We're going to take a look at creating a Pages document. And if I chosen a template, when I open the template, each one of these is a placeholder. So all I would need to do is insert the text or image that I would like to add there. You'll notice it's very nice. It's already designed. It has everything in it that I would need. So there's not a whole lot of creation there when it comes to the layout. This is very nice for the students because it gives them a clean look, a professional look, without them having to figure out how do I design it, and then they end up spending all their time putting in pictures and shapes and designs in it, and it clutters the document. So if you have a template, all you have to do is click on any one of them and you can add, you can type, you can change what it says. If you have an image in the template, you can choose the lower right hand corner, push that plus. It is going to open up the camera roll, or they can take a photo from there, and it maintains the placeholder. We are going to look at a blank document so that you can see all the different things that you can do when creating. So the first thing will be a theme that you can choose. We're going to go with a blank. And when you choose a blank document, it will simply open up. And from here, if I choose blank, I can change the name of the document. That might be one of the first things that I want to do. So I will call this simply test. And now I have my document ready to go. If I click on the page again, you'll see that this is a standard word processing page. Now you may be thinking, well, why would I use Pages as opposed to Google Documents? Well, with Google Docs, you have a lot of great collaboration that can happen. Pages is very good if you want to be adding multimedia. So one of our digital capacities talks about adding multimedia to a document. Pages is a great way to do that because it is a word processor with the additional features of adding tables, images, shapes, videos, all seamlessly in one location. So we'll take a look at adding those types of content in the next video, but at this point we want to look at how we can do a little bit of the formatting. The keyboard on screen that pops up gives me several options such as tab, the font, so I can easily change the font style. I can change the size of the font very easily, add bold. I can justify, center, align right. I can add a paragraph break. I can also, if I have it turned on, use my speech to text option beside the space bar. So the keyboard itself in Pages gives you several quick, easy access features that make using the app very seamless and straightforward. The other thing to keep in mind is the formatting that you have for the page. So let's say I want to change the formatting of the document because I have it, I'm ready to go, but I see the spacing and I want it to be a little different. If you choose the three dots, you can go to Document Setup, and here you can change the border. So if you wanted to change the border, you can change the paper size from US letter to A4. The one thing you cannot do in the iOS version of Keynote is change the orientation of the page. So if you are creating a Pages document or your students are working on a Pages document and you want them to create a landscape Pages document, once you have this document created and it is in vertical format, it is not in horizontal format, you cannot change that. So you want to make sure when they are first creating and choosing their document that they would pick landscape if that's the format that they want or that you would like them to work in. The other thing that you can do is zoom in or out on the page simply by taking your two fingers and moving in or moving out, just like you would on a photo. So you can move in, zoom in, zoom out, and those are your basic things for creating a Pages document in iOS. We'll look at adding content, modifying content in our next few videos.